So API security involves securing data end-to-end, which includes security from a request originating from the client, passing through the network, reaching the server and the backend. So while APIs are a key element in modern businesses, it can be also a major liability if they are not properly secured. These security vulnerabilities can lead to theft of sensitive data such as medical, financial, and personal information, also can lead to data manipulation, and can even result in unavailability of core business functionalities, causing financial losses. So API security is not just about access control to the API. It should consider privacy. It should detect of attacks and have a strategy to take corrective measures against these attacks. The nature of the APIs differ from company to company, right? So organization, it depends on your organization. So any implementation of API security needs to be specific to your APIs and that the data you are dealing with. So some of the aspects that you should consider for your API strategies are can be as follows. So who is the intended audience for your APIs? It can be public. It can be the API access can be public. So which enables anonymous users or registered customers to access them. It could include employees, meaning that APIs are exposed internal to your network, and it could be also partners, so basically trusted parties which can access these APIs. So it's important to identify the intended audience for your APIs. Then so who is accessing the API? So this can be is it a human user? There are user logs to the application, and the application itself accesses the API on behalf of the user, or is it a system? Where user is irrelevant, the application accesses the API as a trusted subsystem. So next thing is, how are these APIs accessed? So that also we should take into consideration. So who really has the control of the environment which the APIs are accessed? So it could be a web application. So in that scenario, end user does not have a complete control over the environment which the web APIs are accessed. So there we have the option to securely store the application keys. So then there can be mobile applications or single page applications where end user has the total control over the execution environment of the API. So we ideally should consider these as untrusted clients. So we should not make API keys into the system, the application themselves. Right, so moving on, so the other aspect that we should consider is how the trust bootstrap should be done. So it can be direct, the trust can be in a direct manner where a user authenticates directly with the API and the API knows how to authenticate the user. So for the simplest example would be authenticating to the API with username and password, right? The trust can be brokered also, right? So the API itself does not trust each and individual user. Rather, it trusts a credential issued by a third party. So for example, if you think options like logging with Facebook or Google, these can be categorized as brokered trust bootstrap. Right, so the other aspect that we should take into consideration is what are the data we are dealing with. So we should clearly identify what data to collect and minimize the data collection as much as possible. The more data you have, the larger the impact will be in the event of a data breach. So same rule applies to the data exposed through these APIs. So unless it's it should be limited to the bare minimum information for the functionality of the application.